Well, News 4 spent yesterday at the White House. It's a project we've been working toward for a long time, and our Michael Cogdill is just back to share more of that journey into history. And Michael, you spoke one-on-one with President Obama yesterday and experienced the White House from end to end. What a plum assignment.
It was a plum assignment. We sure did get to do all that from the South Lawn to the West Wing yesterday, Gabby. We experienced the deep history and the stunning amount of work that accompanies running these United States each day, day after day. On the White House property, security is tighter than anyone can imagine, so it is rare when you get a chance to chat with the President of these United States and take in the long view.
In the far distance, the Jefferson Memorial stands in its rarefied place, just beyond what amounts to the first family's backyard. The South Lawn reclines into that long view that reaches straight into the eyes of the most protected home in America. It's a big place, so I had to ask the President.
Is there ever a honey-do list for the leader of the free world?
There's always a honey-do list. There's something that I haven't done that Michelle will remind me of on any given day. It is true, though, that I've been able to put away my tool belt. I don't have to go around, tinkering around the house. Yeah, usually there are people who are much better at it than I am, who will fix a doorknob or make sure the painting is hung straight.
Now, this is the green room.
Beyond paintings and the color-themed parlors, the White House covers 100,000 square feet full of American history. The curator, Bill Allman, reminded us much of it stays way out of sight.
In fact, there's six stories, but when you stand on Pennsylvania Avenue, you still see basically what looks like a two-story Georgian house.
There is so much history in this house, even in the hallways. If you recognize this corridor here, the carpeting tends to give it away. That's the corridor President Obama walked the night he told America Osama bin Laden was dead.
As I pointed out, there was
Not far from that corridor along the West Wing, the serious business of governing and politics carries on.
Well, I tell you what, Congress obviously is in a polarized mood right now.
But just down the hill of that South Lawn, there is the relative quiet of the vegetable garden. First Lady Michelle Obama's tiny plot produces 1,000 pounds of food a year, designed to motivate a healthy life for everyone.
What do you like to eat out of that garden?
Well, I tell you what, that garden has produced more food than any of us could ever imagine. I don't think when Michelle started it, we realized how bountiful it was going to be. We end up giving away just tons of food to local shelters and food pantries. And it's been a great lesson for me and I think a lot of kids who get brought there about how much food you can produce just on a pretty small plot of land.
And out back of this house that hangs with so many faces of history, just watch what this face did to a flock of reporters who got to hang for a few minutes with the Obama's Portuguese water dog Beau. For all the weight of governing and the politics, at the White House there's always a quiet, long view of the world.
I'm gonna tell you, that Beau is a cool dude. Very calm, very well-trained dog, by the way. And he proved that a dog can cause smiles to break out in the middle of the most serious work we were doing there on the South Lawn and around the White House yesterday. There is the feel of home sweet mansion to the White House. The curator tells me for all the work to preserve the history there, the people who work very hard there also try to remember that it is a family's home and they give the first family all the privacy they can. One other quick thing here. Check this out. We bumped into Betty White at the White House yesterday. I came through a door and there she was sitting on a bench petting the presidential dog. Here she is doing the same thing again. Some photographers found her later there on the South Lawn. She also had an audience with the president yesterday, chatting with him in the Oval Office. We came very, very close to the Oval Office, didn't get quite that far, but hey, I'm no Betty White.